It draws more viewers than the NBA Finals, the Stanley Cup Finals, and the World Series combined.
What do you think when I say the word esports?
The TV was in a bar, the volume was muted, and you're trying to say esports.
Yeah, I am. Dude, Ryan, they have tournaments, man. You can win $1 million.
I'm doing this. I support you.
We're recruiting gamers.
Are you guys with a micro-penis support group?
What? Kid, we lied to your mom. We have average-sized penises and we're starting a kill core team. You down?
We're gonna have a shot at blood match. We're gonna have to do a lot better than that.
I wanna hear those fingers moving!
I feel like I'm just hitting buttons randomly. This is going to be the greatest esports story ever told. And not just because stories about esports are inherently inaccessible and unappealing.
Yeah!
Yay! I used to be better than you, and you hated me for it.
I'm not gonna apologize for my success with dating a model.
Yeah, well, she's a catalog model.
Holy crap, Rylan, when did you get so good?
Yeah, how about that MVP, Sam?
We're good. We have a shot.
Blood match!
It's like the King of Kong! Our first ever blood match!
His team is a bunch of soulless robots.
What did Rocky do to the robot?
Rocky never fought a robot.
Yeah, there was a robot. It was his butler, though. Sure about that?
Yeah, it was Rocky IV.
All right, cards on the table. I've never seen it.
It's back. Sweet, malty, delicious. Sam Adams Oktoberfest.
Hey, what's going on YouTube? This is Kevin McKell. We are back with a new video. I hope you guys had a great weekend. I had a great weekend. If you are our first time, well, how was your weekend? It's good. Wait, I didn't go shoot. Saturday. My cousin, one of my cousins, she and her husband, they're senior citizens. They're in the 7th. They went on this Adele Prom.
Are you serious?
Yeah, down. Yeah. And I went to go see her on Union, but go see them all for their prom. And I stayed there because she left from her daughter. They left from their daughter's house. And I stayed at her daughter's house. All night, you know, family, and you're laughing, talking, and guys. Because earlier that day, I had to sleep all day on Saturday. I was just exhausted. So, I got up like around 4:30, took a shower, went up there, and I didn't get back to the house until like after midnight. It's not a good time. It's kind of good.
And especially, you was all out Friday night on this block.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a hot mess.
And I had a good time at church yesterday. My pastor preached. Oh my God. You get people gotten in the sermon. But it was like one of those sermons that like you needed to be gotten together. Because I've had a few sermons that I've listened to from him where he's got me together. Not direct person, but the sermon itself has got me. Yesterday, a really good sermon. Oh my God. But yeah, Friday night I was here and
yeah, on this block. And we had some conversations. I'm just so mad about one of the conversations that we had.
Dad!
I am pissed off about that. Now, if you're first time watching the School Day Show, please click that subscribe button. Also, everyone that's watching, if you're on your phone, your iPad, your tablet, or your Xbox, your PlayStation, whatever you're watching, click that like button. Also, please share our video to Facebook, Twitter, or whatever social media platform that you use. Thank you so much. And thank you to those who have been watching the videos. So far, the past 5 videos have been up, so this is the 6th, and tomorrow will be the 7th.
Okay,
so make sure that you all stay tuned on what's going on with the Scorpion Show, and also turn those notifications on. There's a bell underneath this video if you're watching on your computer or on your phone, and that way you'll be notified to your phone whenever we upload a video. But that means you must have a YouTube account and you must have an attention to your phone. So that means you gotta be subscribed to our channel to get those notifications, because otherwise, how do you know the video must be? So make sure y'all subscribe to us and turn those phone notifications on. So, we were out on the block Friday night. Good conversation. First of all, Kel can't wait like my kids. But I wasn't ready to go upstairs like that. He wasn't ready to go home. So I said, Costa, what's up? So she comes around with a friend. So, you know, we just having some good conversations, just talking and just, you know, just shooting it and just having fun. So then, you know, we started talking about sex. And during the conversation, she started talking like, I don't like condoms when I had sex. And it's funny because you usually hear guys gotta talk like that. But she, as a woman, she was talking like that. And she was saying, I don't care. And I'm just like, well, you know, you might like sex without the condom, but I mean, you can get a bunch of, there's a bunch of diseases out here. And with some of the strains that's going on, like, sometimes these medicine ain't killing them right? And I just like, you need to protect your body, right? And she just was coming from the point where I can F who I want to F, and I don't have to wear condoms. And I was really like, oh my God, I was shocked, I was getting upset. And it's like, why do I have this conversation with you? Do we get pregnant and not want to be pregnant? And it's like, there's many reasons why you should be wearing condoms. But she just was just like, loud and just saying like, she's not gonna wear condoms, she don't F with condoms, she just don't. And I wanna know, I mean, I know a lot of y'all are anonymous, but, and a lot of females watch our show. Are you one of the women out there that don't like to use condoms, even if you're not in a full committed relationship with someone? Like, I wanna know, like, do you like condoms, do you don't like condoms? Because I just don't like to hear that kind of stuff. And if you had to be friends, especially certain sexual, but especially you don't like hearing those type of stories from people, especially when you had scares yourself or you've been like, oh my God, I hope this, you know what I mean? Yeah. That's not a fun feeling to have. Mm-hmm. You'd be all nervous and like, oh my God. So I don't know. I guess maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, we had a nice 20-minute conversation.
I had to get out of that conversation.
It wasn't going nowhere.
It wasn't going nowhere. I was in there, but then I said, let's get out of this conversation.
Yeah.
I can't
even defend that. Well, there's no defense though. Yeah, so I want to know, like, if you had any girlfriends like that, if you had any male friends like that, what did you tell them? And I'm glad that I don't have to have this conversation with my friends, male or female, because we all know the dangers of HIV, which can lead to AIDS, you can get gonorrhea, you can get crabs, you can, I mean, common or not, you can still get crabs. Herpes, that's incurable. Condom or no condom, you still get herpes. It's like so many effing diseases.
I'm sorry, I hear a child.
It's just so much out there. And you guys have to protect yourself. And speaking of HIV, on October 15th, in a couple of weeks, is the Philadelphia AIDS Walk. And I would like for our viewers that's in the Philadelphia area, I would like to do the walk. The walk is rain or shine, and the walk starts at 9 a.m. and it'll be over by 10:30. So if you're in the Philadelphia area and you want to do the AIDS walk with me, please contact me via social media. Also, if you have any books, music, anything like that that you would like to promote on either of our Instagrams, please contact us via DM. Again, via DM on Instagram.
So you contact him if you want him to promote you on his DM.
That's right.
He will be able to you. Might not need for my DM.
Yes. And right now, I have special rates that I haven't really promoted nobody. So I'm trying to see how it goes. So if you want to test market me, come on through. Or you can go to the Kel's Instagram.
Yeah, I just promote myself.
Yes.
Because like, people that I promote, they get results.
That's right.
And a lot of people hit me up after the fact, you know, and I'd be so happy, especially with the young black small business owners, because I really be happy. I'm like, wow, that's really good. You know, our girlfriend Swanda Braxton, she had bought some hair products from this young lady who follows me and watches us on social media, and the young lady hit me up and she's like, oh my God, I can't believe it. You know, and at first I'm thinking like, well, let me ask Swanda what. You know, she hit me up and was like, yeah, I did that for you because I was going to be a baby. You know, she just, people off,
right?
So if you're interested in doing that, please contact us via DM. And serious inquiries only, okay? Serious inquiries only. So we gotta get into some stuff. Now, on this video, we're not talking about Trump, because I don't want Trump messing with my coins. So we're gonna do Trump on tomorrow's video. But on this video, we gotta get to all the gossip that's going on. Number one, Kylie Jenner. On Friday afternoon, she trended all day. And I mean, it was like losing sleep. About her, and the rumor is that Kylie Jenner is pregnant by some guy named Travis Scott. I don't know who he is.
Yeah, he's a rapper.
Yeah. You know, all these rappers like that. You know,
I like that. I don't think
that's cool
at all.
I do. I like more hip hop, but not too much because these stars. It's not like rap like how it was when we were coming up. But we discussed that when we talked about the Hip Hop Honors video. If you missed that, go check it out. You know, it just don't do it for me like that. And I don't know who Travis Scott is. But it's rumored that Kylie Jenner was pregnant, and she did not deny the rumors. She actually posted some pictures on her Instagram. One was with one of her friends, and she had her stomach halfway showing. And then, that's a black guy.
Oh, yeah, you know.
I mean, I should have known. When did you ever know the
pregnant? Finish! Okay!
The rest of them all mess with black men. Yeah, ain't this the guy that they were saying he was trying to destroy Rihanna's career?
I have no idea about that. I don't know.
Okay.
But she went from Tiger.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But see, I'm happy for her if she is pregnant. But I'm really happy that she's not pregnant by Tiger, even though Tiger said it was his and then deleted it. Because I didn't want Kylie to be pregnant with Tiger's baby, and then their child be either brother or sister, and have also be cousins. Like, that just don't mesh right. Just don't sound right, and that's just nasty. So, I'm just glad that they are not, she's not pregnant by, what's his name, Tiger. And, I really don't care about the situation, but I know a lot of you guys are saying, talk about it, I don't keep up with the Jenners or the Kardashians, but, I mean, Kylie is well paid. She has a lot of, like, hundreds of millions of dollars she's worth. She got cosmetic lines. She's 20 years old. You know, she can take care of her baby. She really don't need to buy the help to take care of the baby. But, you know, congratulations to her if it's true. And they're saying that the baby is due around April. So she's in her early stages of pregnancy. So there ain't no belly bumps showing, but you know, the girls be like, hot, they belly bumps these days. Yeah, did anyone say this? Congratulations to Kylie. Today, there's a story on DailyMail.com or DailyMail UK, wherever the link is. They had a story about Wendy Williams. And McCallum and I also just watched Daily Mail TV, and they went into more detail. But reading the story, you get more details, but it actually shows their receipts with photos and things like that. The alleged cheating affair of Wendy Williams' husband, Kevin Hunter, had an affair with Wendy, where they claimed that he's leading a double life. Now, they also were saying that Kevin Hunter has this is all alleged, okay? This is for Wendy's husband. This is all alleged, where Wendy Williams' husband has a home 9 miles away from his mansion that he lives in with Wendy Williams, and they're also saying that he shares that home with his girlfriend. I don't remember her name, but they're saying the mistress. And they also said that he's been messing with his mistress for 9 years. And they also had pictures of them together, like pictures going to the gym, pictures of them out on the street, picture of Kevin Young at the house. I mean, they had pictures everywhere. I don't know how they get these contact cameras, but they are working. I mean, they came with the fucking receipts. Now, they're saying that Wendy Williams' spokesperson is saying that she's just a friend, and that there's no there, to quote the article. So, you know, yeah, and just like the lady was saying, like, Wendy has to know. Of course, Wendy Williams has to know what's going on, and this is not the first time Kevin has cheated on Wendy, and we all know how Evelyn Rosado threw Wendy Williams under the bus a couple of years ago, when Wendy threw Shane at Evelyn, baby fucked in the cash register, with, Evelyn was out of town when Wendy Williams said, yeah, your husband be buying your shoes for women all the time. Let's talk about that. Let's talk about that on the show. And of course, Wendy never brought it up to the show. And there were also rumors last year that Wendy's was having problems and that they were talking about canceling her show all the time, trying to get rid of her husband because she gets in the way of a whole lot of stuff that goes on with the show. And Wendy Williams' husband is not only a producer, he's also Wendy Williams' manager and stuff like that. So there's no way Wendy don't know what's going on. I didn't know that Wendy's 7 years old. So she looks about 15 years old. I mean, with those pictures that came out with them on the beach, I mean, Wendy just, that was Wendy letting her own hang out. And like she said in our show, I did not even know she was there. She just thought she was on that beach by herself.
That looks like if you're in somebody's house.
You know, but see, they don't know if I had something to do with it. They've been following her for a long time. And they've been waiting to break this story, and they broke it today. A lot of people are talking about it. But, you know, it's not really, but Wendy Williams is not really shocking. And I think also when she wrote that story about Janet Jackson and the Harvey and stuff, and saying that these are things that we say to each other anyway, and her audience is on there. And I was saying, like, she's letting us think on something. But, and, have you been to someone's house with the other people that know that people are there? People are there. Say that one more time. Have you ever been to someone's house?
Have you ever been to someone's house and didn't know the rest of their family would have been there?
No.
That you all agree with the
other thing. If I go to somebody's house.
No, I don't mean like, go, oh, hey, let's chill, let's watch TV. I mean,
to like be intimate?
Yes.
No, I've never done that. Have you?
I know.
Have you?
Yeah,
you know, I'm careful.
I didn't know. I know we get out.
And she's got a part about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, caught on tape.
Yeah, is she here?
So, I don't know. But you know, I'm not worried about this. You got something you want to say to them? Go ahead. It's a whole lot going on. But I'm focused today. I'm focused. I let them stop me. I'm focused to the door.
Yeah,
and I can jump. Front fisties.
No.
So, yeah, so Wendy Williams, girl, you better get it together. And I'm sure you won't be talking about that when you show. But I want to know what's going on. Because Wendy, of course, Wendy's going to prove that she would never tell anybody to cheat, but it looks like she got a lot going on in her house from these pictures. And I mean, you can't deny what all of these receipts.
Right.
You can't say that's a friend. A friend's a family. Come on, man. Right. And they said that he also mentioned his son as his sister.
But then when that people had
some more.
Now, okay.
But Wendy knows, though. It's like, we all say it. She knows from every woman. That's what my mom said. Every woman knows when something ain't right inside their relationship. Today, another relationship. Tamar Braxton is quitting music, and it doesn't even sound like she wants to save her marriage. Now, I don't know if this is just a marketing ploy to get people to buy her album, but Tamar's album will be released this Friday. It's called Bluebird of Happiness, and this is rumored to be Tamar, but it's not rumored, it's what Tamar said about. This will be her last album. She's retiring from music. And she did an interview where she was saying this, like, a lot of stuff going on, you know, her and this and stuff like that. And it basically sounds like she's trying to save her marriage because they do everything together. All I want to say is this, this is not adding up to me on why Tamar wants to quit music or is quitting music. It's not adding up to me. And something I thought about while reading this is that everything that Tamar does, she doesn't do it without Vince. Vince plays some part, a big part, in every aspect of what she did, whether it was with the reel, whether it was on Rex and Family Values, or on Tamar and Vince, on her albums that she put out, on the TV shows that she go on. It's like wherever she goes, Vince is right there, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's the kind of relationship that they have. But also, I think that it's possible for Tamar to have a manager without it being Vince, who's working in her best interest as well. And it would take a lot off the stress of having to do everything it has to deal with your husband first. I think that if she finds a reputable manager or a reputable agency that can help her, it wouldn't put a strain on their relationship.
But that's if Vince wants her to be represented by someone else.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think that right now, Seymour is probably the biggest thing he has.
Besides Gaga.
Besides Lady Gaga. But other than that, I mean, Tamar's pretty big. She's big in her own way. But she's not big where she don't have the Gaga type fans, but she is big in the lane that she's in.
And she has a loyal fan
base. She has a loyal fan base. She's successful in what it is that she does. And I don't know if Vince would want someone else to be over that, because not only is that his artist, but that's his wife. And I'm sure in the back of his mind, I know what's best for you in your career. And in some ways, he's been doing things correctly in her career thus far. Because she went from being Toni Braxton's backup sister to now headlining her own shows in some instances, you know, and being a star on the family's reality TV show. So it's like, you know, to say if he doesn't want her to go somewhere else, he might just want to say that.
Yeah. But I just feel like,
but also we're a couple working with each other. It's going to be
stressful. You might have some ideas, and then like she might have an idea, and then that causes arguments and stuff like that. But then, okay, now that you're putting music, right? You still got this deal that we haven't heard anything that salvaged between you and Steve Harvey,
right?
Steve Harvey. Like you have a production deal with them. You're supposed to have a TV show this fall. Maybe that's been a pushback for the album to come out. She can host some TV shows. She can always come out with a TV show next year, or do hosting specials, or special game network shows like ABC has all the time, like during the summertime. Summer fun and games. It's always they bring them back shows like Password and Pyramid and To Tell the Truth. All that shows are making returns and stuff. Tamar can have a show like that or run a different network. So I don't know what's going on with that, but I guess we'll wait and see. And now she's an independent artist, she's going to have to do a lot of running around, and I'm not sure what else she's done. I haven't heard about her being on any TV shows this week. The album comes out on Friday. This Friday. I want to know what's going on. And I want to know if anybody else is going to ask her about this quitting this music, because, and I want them to dig deeper, because it has to be deeper than that. It could be a marketing program.
Yeah, because I can't understand how you just all of a sudden decided to quit music when you just started, like, really popping off for a couple
years ago.
Like, why all of a sudden now, I want to quit?
Yeah, I don't want her to quit music.
And she's not quitting music, because she's too much of a person who likes the spotlight.
Yeah.
So I can't see her stepping out of the spotlight. I just can't see her. I can't see that.
So hopefully Tamar and Vince can get it together. And if they got to work on their marriage, work on it, or if he's afraid to let loose a little bit, you know, I don't know. It just seems like that's what it is. But hopefully they can get it to work. And speaking of more music news, today, Cardi B has the number one song in the country with Bodak Yellow, and everybody has been so supportive of her. A lot of people, I haven't really seen slander or, you know, negative stuff about Cardi B having the number one song in the country. I mean, the song took everyone by storm. I mean, you can't turn the radio on without hearing it somewhere. Or other people putting it on their Instagrams and dancing to it. Even Janet Jackson took Bodak Yellow and meshed it in to her concert, and Janet is dancing to it. I mean, everybody wants to see Cardi winning, and she's winning. And it's such a good thing to see, because you don't take these reality stars seriously.
Right?
Like, so now you got Tamar coming from Brace and Billy Bodies, K. Michelle coming from Love & Hip Hop, and then you got Cardi, because I don't take Jocelyn serious.
Jocelyn doesn't take that.
She don't even take herself serious. And it's like every time you be watching these shows, you see them in the studio and the song out.
Stevie J told you that she's going to win an Oscar.
Yeah, I remember that. And the Oscar for what?
I think she's met one of the Latin Oscars where they come up
with all the things. Okay.
Has she even been nominated for a Latin award? I don't think so.
Yeah, oh, Jocelyn, right?
Not it. For any award except for the Clark Award show there.
Yeah, no, okay. I think that was what's her name? What is her freaking name? The girl, right? The believe it. I don't think she's got nothing to do, but she was swinging from a pole. You don't see that horn right there.
You don't see that in people's homes right there.
I mean, I've seen them before. I've seen a lot of stuff in horns. But, yeah. Switch it back to Cardi B. Don't do it. I don't think it's going to do it right, but you got to be doing all this. But sometimes it just spices it up, depending on how I'm not swinging. But I got to try to swing it from this. Like on Friday afternoon, that was something. I mean, Morgan, that's something sweet. Shout out to those that was on my Instagram on Friday morning with me and Mikael driving around the city. It was a whole lot going on. A lot. Yeah, and I deleted that video. Thank God. I mean, because I ain't want nobody watching that video. You know, you can scream before when you're out on now. I was just like, no, that's just
resetting. Can I make a live and then scream before the live that I make once the.
Yeah, or
once you, because after I saved the live never saves to my phone. Like, then you
still don't have space on your phone?
You don't have space on my phone.
Well, if it's not saved on your phone, it automatically saves if you go to your videos.
Yeah, then it'll be in there.
Mine is, I'm not going to my videos, but yeah, they,
and the thing about it is, it says on the live thing that
it's saved, that it's not.
No, that, my settings is that when it's finished, it's supposed to save. See, it's on.
Exactly. You should write Instagram that you got people blocked on Instagram.
Yeah.
How come there's nobody blocked on Instagram?
Cause you, oh, it, a lot of people be spam pages. You know, all the comments and like.
Yeah.
What are you
doing? Yeah, I know that one for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, but Cardi B has number one song in country, girl. You got every reason to celebrate. And shout out to J. Cole. He did for something like, you know, don't put pressure on yourself. First of all, he was trying to find out how to get back on. Get on Twitter and do a thread because he has something to say about the small one with President Trump and the NFL. And before he started talking about that, he gave a shout out to Cardi B. Was that like, don't put pressure on your album, just continue to do you, your winning, blah, 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 blah. Right. So it's just like, Cardi, you got all this encouragement from everybody. Even if you got some rappers or some, I don't know if it's female, I think it's more female, that don't want to give you your props, you deserve your props because you, besides Lauryn Hill, are the only female rappers solo to have a number one hit on the Billboard Hot 100 chart.
Now, make sure we clarify that because there's going to be some people. Lauryn Hill and Cardi B are the only two rap female artists whose songs went to number one, and it was just them.
No features.
No features.
Okay.
Just them.
Yes. And that's almost a 20-year span.
Yeah.
Congratulations to Cardi fucking B. Yeah. Everybody needs to give her a chance. Like, and the best thing that I love about her, she's genuine. Like, she is humbled by everything. She's happy. She says the shit that she feels. She talks about, I seen some tweets about her talking about what's going on with North Korea. Why is the president talking about what's going on in Puerto Rico? So she seems to have her head all right. And she seems to have a great personality, so how could you not love her? That's genuine.
She's not a celebrity, she's just a person who accidentally walked through the store and like, wait, this happened. And it's decent. It really is.
I mean, yeah. The rise of her. And I didn't take her seriously. I thought she was Brother Jocelyn.
Right.
When I seen her on Love and Hip Hop,
I didn't take her seriously at all either. Like, I just thought she was funny on the show, but I just.
Yeah, she got her teeth fixed. She's thinking about her bills.
But you know what's so funny? I think this summer it was leading up to this happening. Because it's like when you saw her being greeted by people like Beyonce and Rihanna and Nicki Minaj, giving her props, and then, like you said, Janet Jackson. It's like there's something laid down to happen on her. And now it's like, look, like,
it's going to be, I think she's, I haven't heard on any features yet, but it could be kind of like the blow up like Nicki Minaj had. Like, if she had her. Nicki Minaj was doing those tapes, but they were being played on the radio all the time, and then it led to her doing features with everybody.
It could be. And that would, you know, that would be dope for her.
Yeah.
You know, that really would be dope for her. And now, when you stop thinking about it, all the people that I just named that she's met up with, now she has something in common with
them. Yeah, and
they go at number one.
So you go at number one.
It's like we all are in the same boat.
And they are fans of her.
Right.
She are fans of them.
And that's
Lisa. And she's just like, I can't believe it. Like, this is
First of all, when I saw that video of Janet Jackson dancing, I posted it on my page, and I was like, first of all, anytime you got Janet Jackson dancing to you at a concert, we're talking about a fucking Jackson, not a beast, but a Jackson dancing to you at a concert, it was like, okay, like Cardi.
Yeah, so congratulations to Cardi B. If you have not purchased her single, get Bodak Yellow or iTunes or wherever this is from that, or you can always stream it to the song, propel songs to the number one spot. Also, and on serious news, which I'm not going to get too long, the Anthony Weiner was sentenced to 21 months in prison for sending the pictures of his Weiner to an underage girl. And he even sent pictures of his son being a fan.
He hasn't
had any pictures of pictures coming to this. Is this horrible? And this also led to Hillary Clinton being investigated again once the story came out that he was doing this stuff because they were checking the computer and also found emails that his wife shared to or sent out to Hillary Clinton. Anthony Weiner being only sentenced to 21 months, I feel like it should have been longer because this is not his first offense doing this. And also, he needs to be put on a sexual offender's list. Like, he needs to be on all of that stuff. Whether he had sex with an underage person or not, it shows that he is willing to do this and he planned to need help to do this. If he really wanted to get the help, he wouldn't be doing those things. I feel no sympathy for him. I think he should have been in jail longer. And I think he needs to be registered on a sexual offender's list. There's no reason why he's not on there. He's just corrupting the morals of a minor by doing stuff like this. And come on, like, I don't get how these politicians only get off and get away with stuff like this. They get away with it all the time. They only do maybe bumped in jail or,
I never thought about it until you just said it. But yeah, he's definitely registered for sexual
services. Like, I've had no mention of that at all.
Yeah, I didn't even think about it, but you're right.
Yeah, because if he's willing to do that privately via text, what would he do in person? You don't need Chris Hansen to tell you that he needs to show up on scene to watch Anthony Weiner. He could do something like that. Come on. This is ridiculous. And to the girl from Kevin Hart, because I was waiting for Daily Mail to show up, but bitch, we don't need to see it, okay? This is the thing. You got court. You claiming that you didn't have nothing to do with the video being released, but you had something to do with it.
I also say she didn't know that Kevin Hart was there.
Yeah.
And then all you do is,
cool her. She fucking knows that Kevin Hart is married. And you said you had sex with him 3 times in 3 days? Really? Did you even think to ask him? Are you married? Did you look at his finger? I don't even know if he wears his ring.
She didn't
even talk about Kevin Hart.
She knows who Kevin Hart is.
She didn't have to ask him
again. Yeah. Once he left, all she did was Google.
Yeah. But 3 times in 3 days, must have been that good.
And it lets you know he's married to him.
Yeah.
And he was there.
Yeah.
It lets you know all
he's gone. I mean, you can't.
She refused to figure it out, Kevin, because she didn't care.
She didn't care. And a lot of people
don't. They don't care. They just want to get what they want to get out of it. And then once the rape train stops, you know, it's like, oh, woe is me. I need help now, and I can't believe, you know what I mean? But it's like, with them, all they see with these celebrities, you know, and these sports stars, you have to realize something. When y'all meet up with these girls that are not your wives, or, you know, all they see is cash, changing with cash for the ring, okay? That's what they see when they see you coming. It's a fucking cash register. And they're going to try to get as much out of it as they can. Like, when you blame yourself to this mistress, they've been messing around for 9 years, and she's kept her mouth
shut. She's getting her mouth
shut,
dude.
Yeah. Yeah, she's got her mouth shut. I would keep my mouth shut so tight and closed that every time my family came over and said, no, where did you get the mouth from? I would say, I'm going to lie to you.
Yeah.
When? Doesn't matter. I don't want it.
That's what she did.
Yeah, what are you going to do? Every morning at 9 o'clock, yeah, 9 a.m. or 10 o'clock a.m., whatever
the fuck you're talking about.
That's my life. Yeah. How you doing? How you doing? You actually probably watch The Wedding Morning every morning at 10 o'clock. Every time you see that show on at 10 o'clock, I'll take your check.
Yeah. It's just horrible. And they're like, you know, You gotta come up with better lines. And where was Lisa Bloom? Because you saw Lisa Bloom, I was not having you done that interview at all. Especially if you're talking about, you didn't have nothing to do with it, you're not extorting Kevin Hart. Who do you know down the phone, or who did you get this at the video shoot to try to extort money out of? You did something somewhere. Something,
and if you're not trying to extort them, then why? What is the need of the lawyer?
Yeah, and what are you, what are you on camera for? Talk. You want to try to sue them for saying that you had something to do with it now? You're still trying to get money out of them. Somewhere. So come on. Sometimes it's good all the to come forward after they cheat like you.
Right. What happened to that thing when you cheat and get a mistress?
Yeah, nobody said nothing. They don't know how to be discreet because everybody wants a piece of the fame. The fame, everybody wants a piece of the fame.
Yeah. I told you, Ching Ching, that the cat goes to
Medicare. So that's it for this video. On the next video, we're going to just talk about what happened over the weekend. And that's it. Over the weekend. So thank y'all for watching this video.
Oh yeah,
yeah. And we'll see y'all tomorrow with a new video. Peace.